How does the corona vaccination work? What happens in the body after an mRNA injection? With mRNA injections, it's not the attenuated pathogen that is introduced into the body, as with previous vaccinations, but a blueprint embedded in lipid nanoparticles that causes our healthy body cells to produce a foreign recognition feature of a pathogen, for example, a spike protein, i.e. the famous corona spike. After an mRNA injection, our own healthy body cells are thus induced to produce the recognition feature of a virus in order to later stimulate our immune system to produce antibodies against it. The immune system distinguishes between own and foreign cells. After the mRNA injection, the body's immune system recognizes cells that present the spike protein as foreign and destroys them. This leads to an immune reaction against the body's own healthy cells that produce the spike protein, similar to an autoimmune disease in which the immune system attacks the body's own cells. The immune system has the important ability to differentiate between its own and foreign cells and to fight foreign invaders. As soon as the mRNA enters the cell and causes it to produce the spike protein, the immune system recognizes the cell and the spike protein as foreign, based on the characteristics on the cell surface, the so-called antigens. As the immune system has the vital task of fighting foreign invaders, it now destroys the foreign spike protein and the cells that carry these antigens. The immune reaction that occurs when an invader is fought leads to inflammation. With each injection, the unimaginably large number of approximately 2 trillion particles are injected, sacrificing an unimaginable number of healthy cells. Comparison of the immune response during natural infection and after administration of an mRNA injection with the spike protein. Natural infections affect the mucous membranes of the mouth and nose, which regenerate rapidly, allowing the damage to be healed quickly. With mRNA injections, the natural defense barrier, the oral and nasal mucosa, is bypassed, and the mRNA enters the bloodstream directly. This can cause unpredictable damage to other organs, such as the heart or brain, which have no regenerative capacity. The immune response against the spike protein and the associated cell that attached it onto the surface is similar to the body's immune response to infected cells during a natural infection. To understand how the mRNA injection works, it's important to understand how the body reacts to a natural infection. A virus uses the nose and mouth as entry points into our body and then uses our healthy mucosal cells to replicate in them. The immune system immediately recognizes the dangerous intruders and the cells it has infected and begins its defense. The infected cells are identified as foreign by our immune system, and the so-called natural killer cells, NK cells, kill the infected cells. A key aspect of our immune system is the recognition of foreign and own. It would be extremely problematic if the immune system went haywire and killed healthy, uninfected cells, as is the case with autoimmune diseases. Our body is naturally well prepared to deal with viral invaders. A very special characteristic of the mucous membranes in the mouth and throat is their very high regenerative capacity. These mucous membranes completely renew themselves approximately every 8 to 10 days. During the immune defense of the infected cells, a fierce battle ensues between our immune cells, including the NK cells, and the viral pathogens, in which thousands of infected cells are destroyed. The focus of infection is transformed into a focus of inflammation. We're all familiar with the scenario. Pain in the mucous membranes of the throat, mouth, and nose, combined with coughs, headaches, and colds. Another important characteristic of our mucous membranes in the nose and mouth is their extraordinary sensitivity and their ability to react extremely sensitively to the slightest stimuli. This property proves to be important as it immediately signals to us that something is wrong in the body in the event of a respiratory illness. This allows us to react appropriately by resting, avoiding stress, or seeking medical help. In most cases, the scenario is over quickly. After a successful immune defense, our mucosal cells regenerate completely within a few days to weeks, and we become healthy again. As the entry point for viruses is the mouth and nose, thanks to the body's development over millions of years of evolution, the mucous membranes in these areas have become extremely sensitive and highly regenerative. The immune system has a crucial ability, namely to distinguish between the body's own and foreign cells. After a successful defense, it therefore stops destroying cells. This ability is of the utmost importance, as it would be fatal if our immune system were to destroy healthy body cells, as happens in autoimmune diseases. The natural immune defense begins in the mouth and works highly efficiently, providing an excellent and perfectly coordinated balanced defense against viruses and other pathogens. The immune system learns from such infections and becomes better at fighting these pathogens faster and more effectively in the future. How and where is the mRNA distributed in the body after injection? The mRNA injection consists of the blueprint of the spike protein, the mRNA, which is embedded in very small droplets of fat, the lipid nanoparticles, and thus protected. This mRNA is distributed throughout the body by the bloodstream and reaches all organs. Now let's take a look at how the mRNA injection works and how the immune system reacts to it. After an injection, the lipid nanoparticles quickly enter the bloodstream and, within half an hour, are distributed around the body. In numerous studies, the lipid nanoparticles have been detected in all organs and, as expected, especially in the liver. They have also been found in the brain, which proves that they can cross the effective blood-brain barrier. In addition, they have been detected in the ovaries and testes, which also proves that they can cross the barrier to testicular tissue. Other organs in which the lipid nanoparticles have been detected are the kidneys, lungs, and spleen. Pathological examinations have shown that the spike protein triggered by the mRNA injection and the subsequent inflammatory processes of the immune system can be detected in the heart and on various endothelial cells throughout the body. The immune system and the response to mRNA injections. After mRNA injection, the immune system recognizes cells carrying the spike protein as foreign and destroys them. The human body consists of around 35 trillion cells. One mRNA injection introduces around 2 trillion lipid nanoparticles, LNPs, into the body. In theory, this means that around 6% of all body cells could be reached by the nanoparticles and destroyed by the body's own immune system. Cells in less regenerative organs, such as the heart or brain, can also be affected, which can lead to permanent damage. Through the purely random scattering of the lipid nanoparticles in the body, they then enter the body cells and cause the cells, first in the vascular wall, endothelial cells, and then in the respective organs, to form the spike protein, later to stimulate our immune system to produce antibodies. Our immune system immediately recognizes the modified cells that carry the spike protein on the cell surface as intruders and begins to defend itself. The modified cells are recognized by our immune system as foreign, and the natural killer cells, NK cells, kill not only the spike protein, but all the infected cells that present the spike protein on the cell surface. The affected area is transformed into a focus of inflammation. As the mRNA embedded in the lipid nanoparticles spreads uncontrollably throughout the body, cells are destroyed in areas of the body that may not have the high regenerative capacity and sensitivity of our mucous membranes in the mouth and nose. As a result, cells in organs that are not highly sensitive may suffer damage, and we may not even notice that something is wrong in the body. We are lulled into a false sense of security, although it would be more appropriate to rest or consult a doctor. Furthermore, cells in the heart or brain do not have the ability to regenerate, but form scars and remain permanently and irrevocably damaged. The defense mechanism of our immune system against the foreign spike protein and the cells that produce it is the same defense mechanism as that of our immune system against a pathogen and the cells it infects, but with one fundamental difference. A pathogen normally uses the natural entry portal of the mouth and nose to enter the body. These mucosal cells in this area are particularly well equipped due to millions of years of evolutionary adaptation. The gene-based mRNA mechanism of action bypasses this natural defense barrier of our body and reaches cells that may not be as well equipped as our cells in the mouth and throat. The vascular wall cells, i.e. the endothelial cells, as well as the cells in some of our organs, do not have the very special characteristics of extreme regeneration and sensitivity as do our mucosal cells in the mouth, nose, and throat. Side effects and adverse reactions. With the mRNA injection, an unimaginably large number of the body's own healthy cells are marked as foreign by the spike protein and thus released for destruction by the body's own immune system. The paradox here is that many healthy cells are sacrificed in order to produce antibodies against a virus. In media coverage, however, only the production of antibodies is mentioned, and the mass destruction of healthy body cells is concealed. After an mRNA injection into the arm, the muscle cells are first stimulated to produce the spike protein. But then, the mRNA enters our bloodstream with the help of the lipid nanoparticles. The lipid nanoparticles are spread throughout the entire body via our bloodstream, wherever blood flows. The lipid nanoparticles are so small that they can penetrate into every cell. Our vascular system is lined with a barrier, the endothelial cells. The endothelial cells are genetically modified by the mRNA and stimulated to produce spike proteins. Our immune system now recognizes the genetically modified endothelial cells and the spike protein as foreign and destroys the entire cell. The remnants of the endothelial cells enter the bloodstream and can lead to vascular occlusion. This poses particular dangers as vital organs and cells are not supplied with sufficient oxygen and can die. If a vascular occlusion is caused by dead endothelial cells, it is not a blood clot in the conventional sense. Blood clots are formed from clotted blood, whereas the accumulation of dead endothelial cells is a form that has never been seen before. In this case, the blood clot is not the cause of the vascular occlusion, but the result of the vascular occlusion caused by the many dead endothelial cells. When blood vessels are destroyed and thus become leaky, the mRNA substance enters the cells of the respective organ. If a vessel in the heart becomes leaky, the mRNA substance can reach the heart cells and cause them to produce spike proteins, whereupon our immune system destroys the affected heart muscle cells as a result of the immune reaction. Heart muscle cells have no regenerative potential, are irreversibly destroyed, and scar. The heart can be impaired forever. This is particularly dangerous when cells of the so-called conduction system are affected. If these fail, they can no longer transmit the impulse for the contraction of the heart muscles, which can lead to sudden cardiac death. As the mRNA is distributed randomly, the destruction of cells can happen anywhere in the body, perhaps even in places where cells have no high level of regeneration. If this happens to a vessel in the brain, and the vessels there are destroyed and therefore leaky, the mRNA substance can penetrate the vessel and reach the tissue, the cells in the brain. Now, these cells are also reprogrammed by the mechanism of action of the mRNA so that they produce the spike protein that our immune system recognizes and destroys. Due to the vascular damage described above and the resulting bleeding into the brain, the immune system can also cross the blood-brain barrier and cause major damage there. Destroyed brain tissue cannot regenerate. Humans have around 37 trillion cells. The lipid nanoparticles, LNPs, penetrate the cell together with the mRNA without the cell being able to defend itself against them, as the LNPs are so small that the cell does not recognize them. This means that the normal protective mechanism of our immune system is bypassed to allow the completely unnatural process to be carried out by the mRNA. The vital separation between the body's own and foreign cells is eliminated by the mRNA vaccination, just like in an autoimmune disease. With each mRNA injection, an unimaginably large number of the body's own healthy cells are specifically marked as foreign with a foreign spike protein, and thus marked for destruction by the body's own immune system. As we've seen, this loss of healthy body cells leads to many diseases and is often no longer compatible with life. This means that people die as a result. On the one hand, cells in the heart or brain do not receive sufficient oxygen due to the vascular occlusion that has occurred. On the other hand, these cells are destroyed by the immune system due to the spike protein. This can happen randomly in any vessel and organ. Complications of the mRNA vaccine are not organ-specific. They can vary greatly, and possible links with the vaccination can be overlooked. This is extremely worrying, as mRNA injections can cause completely new and multifactorial clinical pictures. It is a question of benefit and risk. Do I take the risk of uncontrolled inflammatory processes in potentially all parts of my body caused by mRNA injections to produce antibodies against an already rapidly changing virus, where the antibodies may no longer be effective against new variants? With the mRNA corona vaccine, an unimaginably large number of the body's own healthy cells are marked as foreign with the spike protein and thus released for destruction by the body's own immune system. The paradox of mRNA injections is that billions of healthy cells are destroyed in order to stimulate the immune system to produce antibodies. This procedure is very unintelligent, as a very large number of healthy body cells are sacrificed in order to protect against a single virus among thousands of existing viruses. This entails great risks, as the distribution of the vaccine substance cannot be controlled and can accidentally enter vital organs, such as the heart or brain, which can lead to autoimmune reactions and cell damage. The vital separation between foreign pathogens and the body's own cells is eliminated by mRNA vaccinations.